Welcome back, guys, to Pokemon Wise. It seems we've wrapped up the Team Flare storyline, with Team Flare going out in a blaze of glory, or kind of a blaze of failure, firing the super weapon upon themselves. Is Olizandri and all that all gone? I don't know, but powering the weapon, of course, was Yveltal, and now leads our Pokemon team to go around the place. So let's get in some fights with it, though. Holoclip received. What do you want us to do? Because we don't exactly know what we're doing yet anyway. Going for gym badges by the look of it. Do you have a minute? I'd like to talk to you face to face. Let's meet in Curry Way Town. Okay then, but which way is that? I'll take it, seeming the fact that we were shepherded back to Anastar City, as what's further on. So let's get moving, eh? Thank you for the attack power level 1 and the nice. But we're going into Route 18, Vallee Etroite Way. I'm pretty sure I pronounced that all wrong, but still. Roads of rock, roads of steel, here we walk, happy we feel, I'm sure. So, is that giving us a bit of a denotation of what kind of Pokemon we're going to be seeing? A wild girder appeared. Maybe it is, maybe it is. Right then, so we're actually fighting with a Pokemon about the level of the wild Pokemon around the area for once. Should we Dark Pulse? How does Dark do against Steel, then? Not so good, but still did quite a bit of damage all the same. In fact, with Snarl, which is a lower damage attack, could we possibly get somewhere near to a catchable level? Oh no, just a little bit too much. But now that we actually have some proper Dark-type attacks, we're going to be leveling you up a bit all. No problem, because Greninja's all the way at level 65. You are way behind the curve. Way behind. Well, onwards we go, though I wish I had cut right now. Oh no! Should we get out Bibarel? What on earth? Well, it seems Pokemon are firing out of hedges now. My quick ball caught Yveltal, that's just funny. But still, why are you coming out? If you're a bug, you know this is gonna hurt, yeah? It's got its own cutscene. I guess it's Bug Steel as well? Don't know if flying is that good against Steel after all, but I'd have thought it would be super effective against a bug. Right, so it seems we got something going on here. Definitely the typing is not good for our Yveltal. My shorts on, there's no stop me. I can go anywhere. I'm sure you can, somehow. Right then, youngster Jaden. A Scolipede is coming out. That is a big Pokemon you've got there. That is quite large, and our colorings match. Are you a dark flying type as well? No, you're not, but still. I imagine the dark typing might not be that far off. Hello! Just roll over me with some kind of spiked ball thing. Come on, hide up there, Yveltal. It'll be fine. That guy's faster than us. Nastily faster than us, especially with the speed going up higher as well. Super effective fly attacks. Always good. What Pokemon is next, you say? Well, a level up first of all. I wonder what the stat gains kind of look like. With no EVs or anything like that done, no super training. Wants to learn the move Foul Play. Now what kind of move is Foul Play, you say? Well, it does a lot of damage, its accuracy is good. The higher the target's attack stat, the greater the move's power. The user turns the target's power against it. Well, it's got a base 95 power, is it? Well, that one causes people to flinch. Snarl causes people to lower their special attack stat. Should we just go for pure power? Rather than statistically good. People are going to be posting me, oh no, wrong again. Passerby Z gave me capture power here, not that we're going to be able to, but Pinsir comes out. Would you like to meet another big flying attack? Because I need some HP back. Just a little bit, please. Ridiculously powerful. Well, I'll take that as well. A lovely little bit of healing. He says a little bit, but full healing. Oh, bug-type Pokemon, you never do well against flying, do you? And something massive like that is always going to cause damage. Well, youngster Jaden, you are defeated. Scolipede, Pinsir, Oh, don't be upset now. You send them into battle. It was your choice, sir. It was your choice. Well, what's down here? Well, Pokeball. Hyper Potion we will take. Not that we need it with that Oblivion Wing mood. It's just really good. What else? We got a dead end full of grass. Oh, it looks like it'd be that way. Wild Pokemon we shall be facing. We know we don't do exactly that much damage against them, that's for sure. Right, so shall we try out Foul Play next? Well, seems disappearing and attacking again actually does barely any damage. I guess that's because it's turning the opponent's attack power against itself. But, I was hoping to get that. I was hoping that would be perfect capturing level. But still, it seems like I could switch. Really? I'm not doing too much damage. It seems to me that Lucario would probably be reigning supreme yet again. Because these wild goers, they just don't stop coming, do they? Well, this one's got a lot lower HP as a whole. Or a lot lower level by 2, so we'd imagine that translates into HP. In fact, it didn't really do much damage, though made it flinch. Now, will Foul Play work out to put it in a capturable level for us? Yes, it will. Right then. Rock Slide is horrible, though. I definitely didn't want you to be using that against me. With that said and done, time to be capturing another Pokeball, I think. Go! And you act better actually catch it, otherwise we'll have to switch to Venusaur and put the status effects on. Nicely done! Gerudo was caught! And only a little bit of experience, that's for sure. Oh, trainer battles, you give me so much more! This Pokemon is so muscular and strongly built that even a group of wrestlers could not make it budge an inch! Why wrestlers exactly, but still! No nickname for you, get into my box, and we're still only on box 2. That's a bit surprising in itself. Hello! Hyper Pokemon moves just the coolest, I really wish I could use them. I'm sure you do. Surely you've got some techniques yourselves, Battle Girl Justine. Well, it seems I need ourselves a little bit more HP again. So shall we do some horrific draining? In fact, the Pokemon is a higher level than Vettel. Well, that's just not fair. You can't go up high. Ooh, okay. Avoiding my attack, are you? Well, let's hope that your bounce brings you down. There we go. And then Oblivion Wing to restore my HP. How dare you dodge an attack? How much HP is that going to be, though? Full heal again. Lush. I suppose it's half the damage done, so I guess that Pokemon either had 200 HP or it did... Or it counts if it does more damage than the HP the Pokemon has, is the other thing I'd have to postulate. But then all the other things, like typings I postulate, usually go quite wrong. What's going on down there? Ah, a little grind spot to get down to ourselves another Pokeball if we cut the branches that were in our way. Let me tell you about my brother's mysterious power with it. He can reverse Pokemon type matchups. It's really crazy. Normally a fire type move would be super effective against a grass type Pokemon. With my brother's mysterious power, it's the opposite. Fire type moves become not very effective against grass type. What are you waiting for? Get out there and try as many super effective moves as you can, but I'm wondering how he has that power. Oh, I wasn't expecting a visitor in a place like this. You seem to be a pretty good trainer. Sure, you have a rather strange Pokemon battle. I call this an inverse battle. My mysterious power, I will reverse type matchups for a while. Super effective moves will not be very effective. Moves that are not very effective will be super effective. Yeah, it sounds kind of interesting. You may understand inferior, but when you try it, you'll find it's more difficult than you thought. Would you care to try an inverse battle? Sure. Okay, does that mean that moves that don't work at all will now work? And moves that work don't work at all? I doubt it's that way around. Psychic Inverse sent out a Trevenant. Right, so... is he super effective against me at this point in time, in this juncture? And use it... Oh, you're going to protect that attack, aren't you? How dare you? Still, let's test the theories. Not very effective at all. that would have been super effective. Now it's cursed itself, cut its own HP and put a curse on Yveltal? Well, that's no good. Afflicted by the curse, you say? I don't want that to be happening. Well, can we take it down with one standard Dark Pulse here? I'm a bit worried about the curse, mind you. What does it do? I do not know. Ooh, Dark Pulse did take it with critical hit. Now, what does curse do? Okay, it's going to drain my HP bit by bit. It seems to be extremely powerful. So a Flygon, is that like a Porygon evolved or something? What would be super effective against it? What would not be very effective against it? That's what we've really got to think of here. If it's a flying type, would fighting moves be effective? Okay, not thingy, but still. So Dragon Pulse wouldn't be very effective, even though it looks kind of like a dragon to me. Oh well, let's just use a Horse of Fear and hope for the best. This is confusing. I'm bad at type matchups anyway. Right, it still did damage, but not really what we wanted it to do, and every Pokemon seems to be faster than us of late. In the meantime, Rock Slide is superly duperly whoopily effective, and Lucario goes down. This is like the riskiest battle we could get in. Right, so I'm so confused about what would take you down. I have no clue. So Gardevoir, go! Let's just use Psychic. Let's just go for things that we think are neither effective or super effective. Or neither not very effective is super effective. Confusion! Even though it's Psychic I'm trying to use here. Dragon Claw? Oh yes, because now my Pokemon is a Fairy-type Pokemon. A Fairy-type Pokemon it normally would be not very effective against. This is me silently facepalming over here, so Ice wouldn't be very good. Water would be meh. This is very confusing. I'm losing all my Pokemon for this horrible battle. And all my Pokemon are too slow to be able to deal the damage they need to do. Right, so you didn't defeat me in one go. Petal Blizzard should do normal damage. Good. That was good. Right, took another one down. We're 2-for-2 in this weird backwards battle that I... Yeah, this is like the worst kind of battle you could put me in. Why did I accept? It's just not gonna work here. An old Terrier. What are you when you're at home? Well, just send in Greninja. It'll be fine. I'm sure Greninja's Hydro Pump can beat an old Terrier, whatever it is. I'm so confused. You probably hear my voice quite a bit. Right, you are... Flying water? The Smackdown wouldn't be very good against you then. But that would be because you wouldn't. Water normally wouldn't be very effective against you. So yeah! Defeated. I made a good choice for once. Go me! Confusion! Right then. Oh, actually, two of my Pokemon did not get taken down. That battle may have tied me out even more than my Pokemon, I'm sure. You and your inverse battle. Great, but I'm not sure if you really understand inverse battles. Anyway, I'll give you this. We obtained an Oran Berry. Yes, that helped me. That helped me a ton after Lucario's gone down. Thank you. Could have revived him. That would have been equal. Oh, hello. When it comes to climbing, you can ascend or descend. Which do you prefer? Backwards battles, of course. You were challenged by Hiker Oristers. He sent out a Stunfisk. Hello, sir. You are very flat. What moves are great against you, we ask? Question, question mark, question mark? Dark itself is not a move we've been using for type matchups purposes, but revenge doesn't sound that good against me. Stop hurting me! Go Oblivion Wing, frame rate dropping game! Not very effective? Oh, not even really much HP restored there. I knew it wasn't going to be very effective, but I was hoping it would just completely mince it. Now you're revenging me again for all the HP. Right, foul play, go. Surely that's enough to take it down from this point. Good. Static, though. I suppose that was a physical attack or something? And now we're paralyzed. To add on to everything. Right. So, Hycronistus is defeated. My battling luck is going downhill. So's mine, sir. So's mine. Right, so now Yveltal is paralyzed on top of that. Paralyze heal, please. Two Pokemon down. Yveltal being bashed about. It's not going perfect, is it? What's over here, he says. The Terminus Cave, the one that was all alone. Well, we can't use Rock Smash at the moment. Because, of course, oh, we can actually TM it. Oh, but he's knocked out as well. Well, there must be some kind of fossils in this cave, that's for sure. But what else is the Terminus Cave for? It's along our route. Well, steel bugs is what it's for. Right then. Oblivion Wing, go! Restore me some HP! I know you didn't stay up, I was hoping you would just so I could capture as well, but there we go, that's some nice HP back. Oblivion Wing, you're such a good attack. It seems Yveltal is a very slow leveler. Kind of like Gardevoir in that respect, who seems to be a lot slower than you would expect, but down we go. Any trainers within? What is the Terminus Cave and what is it for? Wild Graveler appears. We know you're going to be super effective, sir. Does Dark do much damage against you? Well, it goes for your defense and critically hits you out. I was hoping for a flinch, but there we go. We'll take what we can get at this point. Poor Lucario, poor Gardevoir. There doesn't seem to be a single trainer. Oh, I just skated up that hill, no problem. But there is someone around. Right, so what's going on in here, he says. Wondering ever so politely. Are they building something? Are they mining it out? Another wild Durant? Shall I regain some more HP from it? Or actually, shall I use Fly this time and see if Fly does a little less damage? Up we go, oh! You danced with me. Now you've given me Hustle, whatever that is. You changed my ability using one of your moves. Well, Crunch comes down, but I avoid it nicely. And there we go, capturable limits. That's exactly what we wanted. So, with a Pokeball, Ultra Ball time. A Dusk Ball or something like that would have been good, but let's get you down. Capture, come on. Yes. Another Pokemon caught! Upping our critical capture rate as well. A little bit more HP for that battle, and Greninja grows to level 66. Right then, what is your data? You are indeed Bugsteel. They attack in groups, covering themselves in steel armor to protect themselves from Heatmore. Iron Ant Pokemon, who's a Heatmore in this place? Is he here, trying to prey on them? I don't know. Are you protecting yourself against something that isn't even around? Is stuff jumping on me from the ceiling? The answer's yes. Okay, wild Ariados swoop from above. Now, I'm guessing if I would use a bird-type move on you now, that you'd go down. So, we'll use Dark Pulse again, see if we can knock down your HP. Ah, too much so. Close but no cigar. I bet he was just a little bit in it. Just a little bit. I do wonder what I find in each one of those boulders, huh? What are you looking at? I'm gonna make you help me work if you lose. That's mean, sir. I don't want to work. You look very, very knackered, Sir Narek. Sent out a Graveler when we know that Pulse gets through that. Only if it critically hits again, of course. But considering its strength is pretty high, wouldn't Foul Play work quite well against it? All the same, a normal Dark Pulse does take it out. It does sound like it's being hammered down by Dark Pulse though, however, doesn't it? The noise that goes with it. Another Graveler. Do you really like Gravelers, sir? Or is that just all you could capture in this cave while you were hanging out? Well, we know what works on you. We know you're super effective against us as well, so we do want you to faint. Aww, sturdy. Alright, Stealth Rock. Okay, I don't like the sound of that, that's for sure. Well, may as well Foul Play you this time. It knocked in the face and faint, sir, faint! Chopping through these rocks, Lola, no problem at all! About to send in a golem? Will you switch your Pokemon? Well, I feel like sticking with... No, we've already got you in battle. Sticking with the flying type against what seems to be rock... Oh, Stealth Rock's gonna come into effect now, isn't it? Oops! Golem comes out. Aha! It is you! Aw, oh, pointed stones dug into Greninja? That's just mean! What's more mean is a Hydro Pump to the face! Farewell! Oh, Sturdy again? No, or is it just... Ah! I was wondering if it was Sturdy or not. Earthquake against us! Not gonna do too much damage, but still is quite a powerful move all the same. We could smack it down for Rock, but I'm just gonna go extra sensory here. Ninja! Psychic beams rock you on your feet, defeat you. Critically hit, in fact. Right then, so Greninja, you'll take the experience and work on Naraka's defeated. The battle was a good sweat, even a better workout than all of this digging. I'm sure it was, but with two Pokemon fainted this episode thanks to the inverse battle, I'm gonna head out the cave and heal back at the Pokemon Center, and meet you back here next episode, guys, so join me then as we explore the Terminus Cave and head onwards to see Professor Sycamore once more. Bye-bye.